Welcome to Kratos BI. My name is Chris Wagner, and today we're going to be showing you how you convert a Power BI report to a Power BI data set and how you can make use of that. All right, before we get started, let's frame up the situation. All right, you've got a Power BI report and you love it, right? Love it, love it, love it. You've built out the data set. It's incredible. It does anything and everything that you want it to do. But you're now finding that you want to build other reports off of it, right? Like having more tabs and more experiences inside of the one report is kind of kludgy and isn't doing what you want when it comes to sharing, when it comes to telling a consistent story. So you want to have many reports built off this same data set, but you don't want to be duplicating the data set a whole bunch of times, because then you got to worry about refreshing each one. And if you make a change to one, you know, like if you're changing a DAX measure, then you have to go back and do all the changes everywhere. Just all sorts of bad juju, right? Don't worry. This is very, very common. If you've been working at Power BI for a little while, you're going to run into this like guaranteed, okay? And so there's a real great way to take that data set that's in the report, you know, that data that's in that your awesome report, and make that into a data set that can be used by all of your reports, all right? This technique is called the golden data set technique. Matt Allington has, coined that term. So go out and check out Matt's blog. He's got some incredible stuff. Links down below on this. But let's head over to my desktop and let's go take a look. Okay. So here you are. This is your awesome report, right? It's even called it. It's the awesome, amazing report, okay? You love it. No matter what, you know, you hover on it. You know, it gives you your little readout. It's got everything. This is the bee's knees. Your sales department loves it. This data model that you've built out, it's fantastic. You know, there's tons and tons of stuff that you brought in here, tons of machinations, a whole bunch of measures. I mean, this is the guy. You just love this, right? But you want to build other reports on it. So what do you do in that situation? Don't worry. I got the roadmap for you. All right. So first thing first, we don't want to lose what you have, right? We don't want to lose the amazing report, okay? So first thing that we're going to do is we're going to go File, Save As, and we're going to save this as Amazing Data Set. Okay, so Amazing Report becomes Amazing Data Set. So we haven't lost anything, right? Still have everything up there, right? So I'm going to even, I have another Power BI report here. I'm going to go in and I'm going to open my Amazing Report. Other reports, amazing report, open it. So I won't have lost anything, right? I'll be able to see that they're all, that it's here. So I've got 100% confidence that it's in both places, right? Yeah, I know, no R, right? So I've got my amazing report and I've got my amazing data set. But you say, hey, Chris, I don't really want to be duplicating these things, right? I don't want to have the report both places. How do I do it? Well, that's great. Here's what, this becomes so, so easy. All right. First, you create a new page. And here, I want you to set the page background, set it to black. All right. Then I want you to go to home and add a text box. And I want you to put this in. We're going to format it as such. Data set only, page left blank intentionally. So this is going to be right front and center in your report page. So this is just going to say data set, right? Now, what we're going to do is we're going to delete off all of the other tabs that we have. Remember, this is my amazing data set. I don't care about the report. I have that someplace else, okay? So this is just my data set. I'm going to turn my border off because I don't want that, right? So data set only, page left, blank intentionally, capital B, right? Because this is what we meant for this to be. Okay, this is in place. I'm going to save this. I'm then going to publish this. And when I publish this, I'm going to publish this into my workspace that I've designated for data sets and data flows. So if you don't have one of these, go out into Power BI and create that. Please make sure that if you're going to be sharing this broadly inside your organization, that you that this workspace is a either a premium workspace or premium per user, kind of depending upon your usage pattern. But you create your workspace for your data sets and data flows. You click select. It's going to publish itself out there. And as soon as it's done, I've got a data set that I can build my reports off of. And you say, hey, that's awesome. That's great, Chris. But I still have my amazing report here that is out in the service that I still love, and it's still pointing at that data set. And I don't really want that, right? I want to have this pointing to my data set that I just published. Good news. I'm going to show you how to fix that as well. All right, so I'm going to fire up another copy of Power BI. So I've got three Power BI desktops running at the moment. So I've got my data set one. Oh, it's out there. Yay! And I've got my amazing report. Now, I've got my new report that's connecting out here. So what I am going to do is I'm going to go in. I'm not going to look at my old files. No, yes, I want to review them later. I'm going to first connect to my Power BI datasets. And I'm going to look and see that, oh, here's my amazing datasets. It was just published. This is the guy I want. I'm going to create that link. And now I've got all of that amazingness that was in my previous report. It's accessible from this new pane, so I could build out a new report off of this, or what I'm going to show you how to do now, I'm going to convert my old report to using it, okay? Watch what I'm going to do here. All right, first things first. Now, I know that I use a theme file and a background on my report, so I'm going to go into my my formatting pane. I'm going to go to page background. I'm going to see it's the Focus Slim 1. So I'm going to pop back over here. I'm going to go to background. I'm going to go to add image. I'm going to go into my seeds, seed 2, backgrounds. Now, your backgrounds are going to be wherever you place these, your backgrounds, right? So I happen to know where, you know, this is where I keep all of mine. You know, you're going to keep yours in a slightly different place. Voila. Now I've got my background in place. I can also go in and I can import my theme. So I go to view, go to my themes, and I go to browse for themes. Okay. Add that in. Theme was successfully imported. Good to go. Now, all I have to do is I have to go to my amazing report. Control A selects all of the visuals in my report. Control C, copy. Flip back over. Control V, paste. There we go. And boom, here's all of the report items that I had. Now I called it, this was my scatter chart design. I also had over here an action tooltip. Now, again, Control A, copy. Now there's some things on here that I've got in place. Like this is a custom size page, 720 by 420. So I'm gonna go back over here to my new report that I'm going to be creating, and I'm going to call this one page size custom 720 by 480. I like to do actual size on these types of views because it really helps me understand how big the visual is going to be when users are interacting with it. But I just select here, Control V, and it will have brought everything just the way I wanted to. Now, I call this page on my other page right here. I called this my action tooltip. So I want it to be the same name. Now I go back over and I want to hide it because it's not going to be available. Oh, ha, 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 ha. I almost forgot. On this page, I want to make sure that I identify this as a tooltip page so that inside my navigation on my other page, it's going to show up as a tooltip option. So I select my visual that I use for my tooltips. And then I go into my formatting, go to tooltip. Now you're going to say, hey, Chris, it says action tooltip, but when I hover over it, it's not. This is kind of like a weird metadata thing that gets lost in copy and paste, so just be aware. When I go back and reselect it, so you unselect it, and then you reselect it, and now it works the way we thought it would. Okay, so once that's in place, now what I'm going to do is I'm going to go out and I'm going to go in File, Save As, and this is inside where I keep my Power BI reports. And this is my amazing report, but this one I'm going to call Light. All right, and I'm going to show you why. So save that guy. Now let's browse out and take a look at the size of this. This is another thing that's going to make this super great for you when it comes to building out and managing reports. Look at the size of the light version of my amazing report compared to the size that has the data set embedded in it. We're talking about 75 kilobytes compared to almost 10 megs. Now, that is a massive, massive difference when you're talking about time it takes to deploy a change out into the Power BI service, the ability to manage this code inside of like your GitHub repos or something along those lines. Managing Power BI is always challenging because it's a binary file. You can't break it out. You can't like do change tracking and whatnot on there. By separating out my data set and my report, it becomes much easier to manage my code of my data set in one space and then my code in my report in another. Using this technique is super helpful. Thank you guys so much for joining me today. I really appreciate it. Taking that report that's highly curated and that you know and love the data set that's behind it is super common. It's one of those things that, you know, is the natural evolution of data exploration, running and iterating through something quickly until you get to a model that you really love and can work with. Then you promote that up and make that more broadly available. This is one of the best patterns when it comes to business intelligence development. I hope you like this content. If you did, hit that thumbs up button, subscribe to the channel, turn on that alarm bell so you get notifications every time I post content. Thank you all very much. You guys are the best. Peace.